A common response I get when people find out I work in the field of mathematics education is some statement along the lines of how they're not good at math. And that's usually followed by a couple of horror stories from when they were a student. And it just breaks my heart because nobody should have to feel this way about mathematics. And I think we can fix this, but what we need to do is redefine what it means to be good at math. Here's where the problem begins. We have had this concrete representational and abstract model of math education since the early 80s, and for a long time it was seen as a linear progression where young students are introduced to math ideas using concrete objects, and then over time they begin to build pictorial representations from there, and when they get comfortable with that, they move on to thinking about the math abstractly. The problem with interpreting CRA as a linear progression is there's a natural tendency to see the last stage of the progression as the overall goal, and then that becomes the focal point for instruction. I developed this visualization where we consider CRA as three distinct islands as a way to help us understand the problem with the conventional interpretation of this model and to help us revise our thinking about CRA in today's math classrooms. So historically, we've placed a big emphasis on pushing kids to get to abstract island as fast and as early as possible and by any means necessary, including tricks, memorized procedures, and over scaffolding. Students are then celebrated when they can work abstractly in math, whether or not they actually understand why their procedures work. Likewise, we may devalue concrete and representational islands as wastelands that we don't want our students lingering on for very long. We would then work really hard to get the kids off those islands so they can live on abstract island with the honor and distinction of being a good math student. The danger with this thinking is that the island you're currently on often determines your mathematical identity. Students who make it to abstract island are celebrated as mathematically capable and given distinguished labels such as high flyer or advanced, while the students who are on concrete and representational islands are often seen as struggling students or low kids in need of intervention. And these labels often determine how students are treated, which then reinforces their mathematical identities. We need to fix this. This misinterpretation of the CRA model creates scenarios where a certain kind of thinker gets all the praise and all the distinction of being a mathematically capable student, while the students who think differently are devalued. So a danger with these labels is that they can also be inaccurate. There might be a student who has really good memorized procedures. They don't know the math that they're doing, but they can remember all the steps they need to do. And so they'll crank out fast, accurate answers really well and get celebrated for that. That becomes the high flyer. And the class knows that because it's reinforced within the classroom. Likewise, there may be a student who has a rich, deep conceptual understanding of the math, but they might have a slower processing speed, or they might need to sketch their idea out and sort of see it so that they're solid with their understanding of their procedure, and they get called low because they're not performing on that abstract island at that speed that's been celebrated. In this case, we have two students who are both mislabeled. So one's being rewarded as being mathematically capable, but they don't have that understanding. And when eventually they get to a level of math where that understanding's necessary and they don't have it, their whole identity crumbles because for their whole life they've been seen as the high flyer in math, and now they're not. And that can be really devastating for kids. And likewise, for that kid that's a careful thinker that doesn't crank out answers, but is a really rich conceptual thinker, they're reinforced that they're not good at math. And so they may walk away from the subject. They may avoid it. They may start to doubt themselves and have math anxiety as a result of these labels that we put on kids. And so we're giving students wrong messages when we start to label students as math capable or not math capable based on the kind of thinking that they do. So here's how we can redefine what it means to be good at math. First of all, let's understand the islands. So concrete island, this is where we're making sense through concrete thinking. We need objects. We're able to build things and see them and manipulate them. There's a lot of power in being able to make models and play around with these models to understand the math. Now, as we develop our thinking, one of the things that we can start to do is design representations of those concrete models, and we can make connections. So instead of building with base 10 blocks, we might draw a base 10 model. This is representational thinking. Now, when we go from one island to the next, we build a rickety bridge mentally that connects these ideas. And it's rickety in the beginning because it's new thinking. So as we start to think representationally, we can go back and connect that representation to our concrete models that we've been thinking about. And as we go back and forth across that bridge, we redesign the bridge. We build stronger supports and it becomes a much stronger bridge. So eventually, by connecting those two islands, we now have a really good, strong sense of this math idea through a concrete model and through a representation that we can make sense of. Likewise, when we do the same thing of thinking representationally or concretely, and we move over to start to think about the math abstractly, we build another rickety bridge. So we might think about decomposing numbers and breaking it up, but it's really important for us to go back and consider how that looks in our representations or with our concrete objects. And as we go back and forth across that bridge, it gets stronger. We build stronger connections so that in the end, what we have by exploring math through these different ways of thinking is a good solid connection between all three islands. To me, this is what being good at math looks like. It means that we have the ability to think abstractly, but we can also make connections to representations, and we can back up our thinking with a concrete model if we needed to. It's important to note two other things with this. First is that this is not linear. So you may have a student whose first way into the math is to think about it abstractly, but there's benefit in them going back and thinking about how their abstract thinking connects to visual representations or concrete models. Likewise, a lot of teachers may find also that they need to go back and revisit representational and concrete island. I know I did. I wasn't brought up that way in math. Everything was abstract to me. And so I found great benefit as an adult going back and trying to understand the math using visual representations and concrete models. What I like about this view of what it means to be good at math is that it's inclusive, right? So we have concrete thinking, representational thinking, abstract thinking. Every one of these islands, we're highlighting the thinking that's involved there. So we're not saying it's a high flyer who's on abstract island or a low kid who's thinking concretely. The idea is that no matter which island you're on, you're thinking. There's really strong reasoning and understanding at any one of these islands. And so being good at math means you have bridges that connect those islands. You understand fundamentally how the different ideas connect. And that's how we authentically include all students. So if you give a problem to the class and you have some kids who approach it abstractly and some are approaching it with a representation and some are doing a concrete model, what's great with that is as you come together to discuss these ideas, you can then have the kids build those connections. So as you ask someone, hey, can you show me where is the 64 in Julian's model? Or in Sarah's representation, can we see where that decomposing of the numbers happened? As we ask the kids to start building those connections, that's the bridge building. So what we're going to do now is define being good at math means having this flexible thinking with strong bridges that connect it. And being a good math teacher means you're a good bridge builder. You're helping kids to see the connections among all of these ideas. And hopefully when we do that, we start seeing a reduction in students who identify themselves as bad at math just because they haven't made it to a certain island within a given period of time. We want to value the thinking of all students. And when we do so, we authentically include all of our students in the math class and help everyone identify themselves as mathematically capable. So let's work together to redefine what it means to be good at math. Let's get rid of these labels of high flyers and low kids, and let's start thinking about how our students are approaching these ideas and supporting them at every stage of their journey so that people have good, positive mathematical experiences.